Mr. Mayor, tonight we have had the usual debates on the fiscal and budgetary constraints of the council and how we prioritise taxpayers' money to deliver services. But the fact is, Mr. Mayor, this issue, the Lindbergh School, is not about money. So much has already been confirmed throughout this entire process, both by cabinet member and by council officers. Mr. Mayor, this isn't about cuts from above, it's about choices on the ground. Choices in this town hall and in this chamber this evening. It's about how we choose to care and educate for some of those vulnerable children in our community. Children with some of the most profound and multiple learning difficulties. And Mr. Mayor, surely there can be no doubt that the excellent caring and learning environment provided to the children of Lindale School for so long should continue to be done so at the Lindale School in Easton. The aspiration should not be for imitations of the Lindale School. We have the real thing right here in Wirral. Surely members will join me in the fight to keep it. Mr. Mayor, the council needs to listen to the real experts in this issue. The parents, the staff and the carers of the pupils of Lindale. These families who have stood steadfast in defence of this excellent school. We shouldn't be blindly accepting the views of an expert consultant who charged us £10,000 for the benefit of their advice, and as I've learned today, an extra £500 when called to give evidence at the polling. Mr. Mayor, the Lindale campaign was, of course, and as we've heard tonight from other members, being recently boosted by the experience of Dawn Hughes and her daughter Ellie. I know that Dawn is in the public gallery this evening. She secured the backing of a tribunal in her battle to keep Ellie at the school, which gives her so much security and comfort. Mr. Mayor, if a learned and I'm sure very distinguished tribunal judge and her two lay panel members recognise the uniqueness of Lindale School and the real harm moving children from this environment can cause, then why can't Wirral Council? Mr. Mayor, I know some of the Labour members are very uncomfortable with the decision to close Lindale School, and I appeal to them to make their votes count tonight. This amendment, this second amendment, does not put the Labour budget at risk. It corrects an appalling decision which had never been made, and it halts the anguish which is being poured upon some of the most vulnerable families in our society. I know that it's difficult to vote a different way than friends and colleagues of the same group, and I should know, as I'm probably going to do that at item 7A. However, Mr. Mayor, this is too much of an important issue to be decided upon by an imposed party whip, or as Councillor Sullivan alluded to, the block vote. I note that neither the leader of the council nor Councillor Toby Smith, the cabinet member, mentioned the Lindale School in their contributions earlier. I hope members will not forget Lindale amongst the political wrangling of tonight, and vote to keep this crucial and vital school community.
Conservative-led government have achieved and ensured Gardens. A council that eradicates the blight of flight of him, and a council which will never tolerate fraud and dishonesty, as well as being a council which respects other people and believes those who have worked all their lives should benefit from a council tax discount when they reach the ripe old age of 70 years. All this, Mr. Mayor, can be achieved because instead of charging revenues for support to trade union officials, flouting the bill for councillors' training and exorbitant tax affairs. Supporting flawed work programmes, hoarding council taxpayers' money and balances, and loaning out part of our £147 million cash in bank to other councils at a minuscule rate of only 0.5%, and then allowing those councils to reloan that money again at up to 9 times higher. The money belongs to the residents of the world, and it must be spent for them, on them, and on services which matter to them. I urge the council, Mr. Mayor, to support our amendment.
£350,000 in a series of
apprenticeship programme and fund a further 12 places. We will remove charges for replacement grey bins and reduce charges for replacement green bins, as well as offering a free of charge bin repair service, as well as funding a campaign to encourage greater recycling. We will reduce the burden of increased household bills for our residents by increasing council tax for the third year. Mr. Mayor, this is all good news and a budget to be proud of. As we go forward, we will now enter a major transformation phase with all of our services as we implement our commissioning strategy to focus on new models of service delivery to complement those already in the pipeline with the schools trade service and the local authority trade company. Excuse me. Mr. Mayor, I commend the budget to council. I'm proud of this budget. I'm proud to be part of the Labour administration. And as we go forward, I urge all councillors to vote for us and vote and pray for the return of the Labour government on the Sunday.
Reserves. Council Trina Johnston, I think Trina Johnston's contribution, who said how proud she was that the Labour Party was supporting trade unions. Well, can I just remind you, Trina, actually, it's the taxpayers' money. It's not the Labour Party that's supporting it. It's using the taxpayers' money to actually spend it.
Just remind people, if you mention another person's name, you're about to get a reaction, so we just carry on.
It was in fact Trina Johnston, and she did say she was proud that she was using taxpayers' money to back up the Labour Party. And while we're at it, Mr. Mayor, again, we've heard these comments about rape and analysis and this and that and all the rest of it. Actually, there seems to be a complete lack of understanding in this council, and certainly in this chamber, that the council doesn't have any money of its own. It belongs to the hard-working taxpayers that we're all. So, £142 million cash in bank, that belongs to the people that we're all. £87 million in reserves, that is money that's already been taken out of the people of Wirral's pockets. And £17 million in general fund, a further £17 million in general fund balances. When on earth will the Labour Party understand that is money that belongs to the people of Wirral? They don't have any choice whether they pay their taxes or not. It's the taxes are levied by this council, and that money belongs to them. And they should actually, Labour Party should start acknowledging that. Just remind you, Councillor Sullivan, it was a national socialist. So just to remind you, probably would have agreed with nationalising the trains. That's what I quite probably did. One of the key elements, I also just want to finish it, Mr. Mayor, issues I just want to cover up. We're told that the children's centres are being kept open, we're told libraries are being kept open. Actually, they're not. They're being stripped of children's centres. Services, they're being stripped down. What's actually going on? And libraries are having rounds, because, I mean, to say libraries are still open, they might be open one day a week or whatever it is.
Representation period regarding the proposed closure of the Lundell
the school. Cameron's on the 17th of December took the difficult decision to close the school with an agreed closure date of 31st of August 2016. At this meeting of the cabinet on the 17th of December, members took into account the full range of issues and themes which emerged during the representation period. Can I remind members that the report to cabinet on the 4th of September contained a detailed account of the outcome of the consultations held across the world and the SEN improvement test? Cabinet decided the closure because the viability of the school is compromised by its small size and falling role. There are currently 21 children on the roll of the school. Members will be aware that there has been uncertainty about the future of the school for a number of years now, and that uncertainty has been resolved with the Cabinet's decision to close the school. Following the school's forum on the 14th of January 2015, schools have already been consulted on the school's budget for 15-16, and this was agreed by Cabinet on the 10th of February. Taking all these factors into account, I do not believe it is a viable option to anticipate that the school's forum would vote in favour funding or retaining the Lindale School. This is because there are currently 21 pupils, as I said, on the roll, and this has been reducing in recent years. There are two other primary schools for children with complex learning difficulties, including children with profound and multiple learning difficulties, which can provide good enough or better opportunities for current pupils at Lindale School or future primary age children with PMLD. The suitability of both of these schools extensively considered and reported in the regions. The Council has given careful consideration to its statutory duty to ensure that there are sufficient school places with fair access to educational opportunities. It's carefully considered the correct statutory processes and guidance that we follow, which includes careful consideration in the Special Education Needs Improvement Test and Equality Impact Assessment, the size of the school and its falling role, and the availability of other suitable primary schools in the world. It has taken account of all the views, representations, and has considered the details and implications, including the financial issues, and concluded that the closure of the school is the most viable option. Mr. Mayor, taking all these factors into account, I cannot see that there is any basis for seeking a revocation notice to consult on proposals to stop all current and planned action being taken to close the Lindale School. Similarly, there is no basis, I believe, on which to negotiate the school's forum to consider allocating money at the detriment of other schools who are already experiencing enormous financial pressures due to the allocation of a flat cash budget and increasing pressure on all schools to deliver a balanced budget. Mr. Mayor, I do want to acknowledge that this has been a difficult and uncertain time for families and children who live in a school and their staff, and that every effort will be made to ensure that there are good plans for each and every child alternative school provision with strong plans for transition in place well before the school closes in July 2016. So, Mr. Mayor, that's my response on the Lindale School. If I could just briefly make some comments about the budget. Just picking up some of the issues that colleagues have raised. I mean, I was interested in the debate we got into, I think, Councillor Cleary and Councillor Cleary seems to be the only member of the chamber tonight who's against the council tax increase. And I just wonder, Mr. Mayor, if he's supporting the Green Council in Brighton, which is actually proposing next year a 5.9% increase in rural tax. I personally think that would be madness and it would really hit those families the hardest. I don't know if that's his position, but perhaps at some stage he'll make it clear. If I could say to Pat Cleary, if he really wants to distance himself from the austerity policies of the Tories, then he needs to stop voting with them. Yeah. On street lighting, I just want to make a point to clear up some Yes, we do have a backlog of street lighting repairs, but we have taken on through our contract additional electricians. The latest information I have is that there are currently 469 outstanding repairs, and that backlog is being reduced by approximately 280 jobs per week. And I'm pleased to inform council tonight, I'd like to thank the contractors, that we expect the backlog to be completely cleared by March the 12th, which I think is The Lib Dem group who were in denial about their culpability for all of these cuts, or a Labour group who has balanced the books, protected frontline services, safeguarded vulnerable people, and kept council tax bills down, and led the fastest turnout of any council in this country. So there, when we come to vote tonight, I know who I want to vote for. It's this Labour.
Regarding school budgets. So we go into Garland, sorry. Okay, that vote's been counted. It's 26 votes for, 37 votes against, 1 abstention. Are you happy with that count?
Not happy.
About that, yeah, 5 votes, but that's got the numbers. Okay. Moving on to the third card vote, and that is on the Conservative Group Amendments moved by Councillor Jeff Green.
Against.
That's a dirty.
Against.
Against.
That's Aubrey.
Against.
That's Patrick.
Against.
That's Flo. That's the Reilly. That's the Reese Jones.
Against.
That's the Rennie. That's the Roberts.
Against.
That's the Rollins.
Four.
That's the Salter.
Against.
That's the Harry Smith.
Against.
That's the Turner Smith. That's the Walter Smith.
Against.
That's the Spriggs.
Against.
That's the Stapleton.
Yes.
That's the Sullivan.
Against.
That's the Sykes. That's the Walsh.
Against.
That's the Walsh.
Four.
That's the Richard.
Against.
That's the Iron Williams.
Against.
That's the Jerry Williams.
Yes.
That's the Steve Williams.
Four.
That's the Williams.
Four.
That's a Sullivan.
Four.
That's a Sykes.
Against.
just the second amendment numbers don't tally up with the fourth amendment. Add 4,000 by 2 votes, and just about to figure out which one.
Incredibly impressed with
Davis?
Four.
Councillor Phil Davis?
Four.
Councillor Bill Davis?
Four.
Councillor Dodgson?
Four.
Councillor Ellison?
Four.
Councillor Ellis?
Four.
Councillor Phelps?
Abstain.
Councillor Fraser? Gilchrist?
Four.
Councillor Green?
Four.
Councillor Gregson?
Four.
Councillor Hackett?
Four.
Councillor Hay?
Four.
Councillor Hayes?
Against.
Councillor Andrew Robson?
Four.
Councillor Cathy Hudson?
Four.
Councillor Wardy?
Four.
Councillor Johnson?
Four.
Councillor Adrian Jones?
Four.
Councillor Chris Jones?
Four.
Councillor Kelly?
Four.
Councillor Leach?
Four.
Councillor Hackett?
Four.
Councillor Marlowe?
Four.
Councillor Meehan?
Four.
Councillor Mitchell?
Four.
Councillor Moody?
Four.
Councillor Muspratt?
Four.
Councillor Woodblock?
Four.
Councillor Norbury?
Four.
Councillor Patrick?
Four.
Councillor Cole?
Four.
Councillor Reedy?
Four.
Councillor Rhys Jones?
Four.
Councillor Rennie?
Four.
Councillor Roberts?
Four.
Councillor Rowland?
Four.
Councillor Salter?
Four.
Councillor Harris Smith?
Four.
Councillor Jones Smith?
Four.
Councillor Walter Smith?
Four.
Councillor Spriggs?
Four.
Councillor Stapleton?
Four.
Councillor Sullivan?
Four.
Councillor Sykes?
Four.
Councillor Walsh?
Four.
Councillor Watt?
Four.
Councillor Whittingham?
Four.
Councillor Irene Williams?
Four.
Councillor Jerry Williams?
Four.
Councillor Steve Williams?
Against.
Councillor Williamson?
Four.
Well, Committee, which are the cabinets held on the 10th of February, as they probably made by the leader.
So moved, isn't it?
Probably seconded.
Yeah.
Do we need a vote on that? All those in favour, please show.
No idea.
You go down the record.
Keep that going right to the end of the year. So thanks everybody.